How you doing, guys? Got some parts in the mail. This is the new gear case cover that I got from a very good, or pretty well-known RJ parts guy. I'm not going to mention his name. I don't know if he wants me to mention it on YouTube, but let's just say if you know RJ's and you go to like wheelhorseforum.com, Red Square, you'll see this gentleman's name pop up as a parts guy for RJ's. I go to him every once in a while when I do need parts. He lives in Michigan, let's put it that way. All right, what we have here is a gear case cover, which he sold me. It's in really good shape. I mean, if you remember from the, I believe it was the last video, I did a quick excerpt picture, and I will do it again right now. As you could see, those nubs were destroyed, and these nubs are nice and high, nice and tall. And this is where that little spring from the paw clicks on these, and that's what causes the resistance to go back and forth, causing the paw to go in and out. With that being said, this is a real nice gear case. I mean, it's dirty. I mean, I had to scrape some, you know, some stuff off it here and there, but we'll get it all cleaned up. I'm going to try to spin it over with one hand. Needs a new grease seal, obviously. But I went over this entire thing, quickly ran a thread chaser through all the threads on the gear case cover, and they all were, you know, good. There's nothing wrong with it. So it just needs a good cleaning, and we have a perfectly good replacement gear case cover for that tractor, the 56. Now, as you know from my prior videos, the tractor was missing two things, an implement lift handle and the actual rear hitch. That wasn't part of the deal, but I took the appropriate amount off the price of the tractor in order to locate those parts, and the same gentleman that sold me this gear case cover also sold me those other parts, and they are right here. Real nice lift handle, patina just right for the tractor. Everything works on it, and the hand grip itself is in real good shape. Real happy with it. Spring is in good shape. Everything springs back. Nothing looks like it's too worn out. Nothing actually even looks worn out. And this is off of an FJ35 because it doesn't has the straight style indicator. Doesn't have a rounded corner one like the later RJs did. The other thing I picked up from him was a rear hitch. Now this rear hitch is for a 1957. This is not a 56 hitch. And the way we know that is this one's made out of basically sheet metal. This was a standard 1957 design. The 56 version, or the early 55 into early 56, it would have been made out of band iron. You know, a side piece would be band iron, top, bottom, and the other side. So four pieces of band iron welded together. It probably would not have had this, which is the stabilizer. That came a little later, 56. So an early 56 probably wouldn't have had this. But all the other dimensions are the same. The same dimensions from here to here, 3/4 inch. Pipe. It's not all bashed up, you know, it's nice and smooth. It's not all caved in. The actual opening is nice. He had a 56 one, but it was pitted to hell. And it was then the T piece that this thing hooks into was actually fused into it. And I kind of went back and forth debating whether or not I wanted a 56. The correct 56, but then he showed me this one, and this one was just so clean and so nice, and he wasn't going to charge me any more for it, basically. So I said, you know what, send me the 57. I'd rather have a nice part on the tractor than basically a part that is going to look like junk. And cool little tidbit here, he threw in the original style locking pin. So we got a bunch of things going on. It's cool. I got a couple more parts coming. I got another brand new paw and some new springs showing up for it. So I should have everything but one paw and the teeth on one of the hubs. That's it. I already have a motor ready to go on it, so it should be just a straight take apart, clean, fix a hub, fix a one paw, and this guy should be running. I really wasn't planning on doing all of this during this fall, but I might be able to get this one done by fall time. And just for a little tidbit, the very drive has been worked on. I got a video put together for that one there. Okay, thanks a lot, guys. I appreciate all your interest.